Hello all, welcome to Whisper Theory Part 1. This is a question from December 2013. The geometry with lone pairs, we have to consider lone pairs also, around central iodine in I3 plus and I3 minus ions respectively are. Now let us draw the Lewis dot structure. The Lewis dot structure for these ions. Now in the Lewis dot structure, we have to remember that iodine belongs to group 7. So valence electron will be only 7. So valence electron is 7. We are concerned only about the 7 valence electron and none other, not the other electron. Now in iodine, the central iodine should have 7 valence electron. Okay, so I have put the 7 valence electron. Now the interesting thing is that when you consider I3 plus, there's a plus charge here. I'm considering the first ion. There's I3 plus charge. Since there's a plus, that means a loss of electron is there. So I'm going to remove one electron from here. Okay, since there's a plus charge, I'm going to remove this electron. And now this iodine is in the plus state. Regarding the peripheral iodine, we have another iodine here. Okay, it also has a 7 valence electron which is going to pair with this electron, and then we have another iodine here with the 7 valence electron which will pair here, and overall we will have a plus charge. Now this is the Lewis dot structure. Now if you draw it properly, we will have two peripheral iodine, okay, and then we will have this 6 valence electron, and then one electron which is bonding, or a bond I can show, and then the central iodine. We are mainly concerned about the central iodine because the question is central iodine, we have to check for the structure. So this two lone pair of electrons, we have a lone pair which I am drawing it, a two lone pair of electron. Okay, now regarding the shape, if you are observing iodine, it is having this shape, and this is tetrahedral shape. So the shape in this case, it is tetrahedral. In the next case, we were having I3 minus. So there's a negative charge over here that we have to consider. Negative charge means we have to add one electron. We have to add one electron to the structure. Now we have three iodines. So the central iodine again belongs to group 7. So valence electron will be 7 only. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and we'll put a 7 here. So now 7 valence electrons are there. Now the next case will be, since a negative charge is there, we have to add one electron, that I will add it here. Okay, so this is the electron that we are adding. Now from the peripheral, we will have two iodines approaching. We have iodine with the 7 valence electron. It will be combining with this electron. Since electron is here, another iodine will be approaching and it will be pairing up with this iodine. Now how many lone pair of electrons are there? 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so since 3 are pairing up, so the structure will be the iodines with a bond with the central iodine, and the central iodine will be here with how many lone pair of electrons? 1, 2, 3. So 3 lone pair of electrons will be there. Yes. So the structure here will be iodine has 3 bonds here, the lone pair here, and then here we will have the iodine. So this structure, this geometry, it is trigonal bipyramidal. So this is the trigonal bipyramidal structure.